next paper comes from the University of Kentucky, and Dr. Burton Davis will be speaking on synthesis, characterization, and catalytic properties of rhenium promoted cobalt catalysts. Oh, sorry.
Good afternoon, everybody. My topic of my talk is synthesis, characterization, and catalytic properties of rhenium promoted cobalt catalyst for research of synthesis. The most commonly used catalyst for research of synthesis are nickel, ruthenium, iron, and cobalt. The ruthenium catalyst produces too much methane and nickel carbonyl, which is soluble in liquid phase. And ruthenium catalyst is very expensive and too rare to use in commercial plant scale. So the iron and cobalt is the mostly useful catalyst for industrial scale. So iron is cheaper, but it is active for water gas reaction, and cobalt is expensive compared to iron, but there is no water gas reaction. In the recent synthesis research, is very focused on to prepare the more stable catalyst. So many promoters have reported for the cobalt catalyst that platinum, rhenium, ruthenium, potassium, and lanthanum. But few reports are available for the rhenium promoted cobalt catalyst for FT synthesis. So this motivated us to study the rhenium promoted cobalt catalyst in details. We carried out our FT research of synthesis in a 1 liter continuously start tank reactor. So there are few advantages of CST reactor. Due to the steering, it has efficient heat transfer and uniform temperature profile, and catalyst can be added or withdrawn from the reactor. The outline of my talk contains preparation of cobalt catalyst and characterization by using different techniques like temperature program reduction, and to find out the reduction temperature, and hydrogen chemistry of cell to find out the percent dispersion, and X-ray diffraction to find out the phase and cluster size of the metal. The catalytic activities was carried out in a 1 liter CST reactor, and the different parameters were studied: the loading of promoters, sequence of addition of promoter, and effect of solvent temperature and pressures. And finally, we compare the catalytic activity of promoted and unpromoted catalysts. The catalyst prepared by three types incipient wetness impregnation method using cobalt nitrate is the precursor. After each impregnation method, the catalyst was dried at 80 degrees centigrade in back under vacuum. After drying the catalyst, the promoter was loaded by the incipient wetness impregnation method using rhenium oxide is the precursor. The catalyst was calcined at 400 degrees centigrade for 4 hours and reduced at 350 degrees centigrade for 10 hours in the flow of 30% hydrogen in helium. In this table, the catalyst used in your present study, we have used the support, the condium ester catalogs, gamma alumina, the surface area is 200 meters square per gram. We have also prepared a catalyst that is changing the sequence of addition of promoter. The promoter was added before the addition of cobalt. The temperature program reduction of the catalyst was carried out in a G-ton Altamira AMI 200 unit. The calcined sample was heated to 350 degrees centigrade in flow of argon to remove the traces of water, and then cooled down to 100 degrees centigrade in flow of argon, and then increased the temperature to 800 degrees centigrade with the heating rate of 10 degrees centigrade per minute in a constant flow of 10% hydrogen in argon, and the TCD signal was measured. And to find out the reduction temperature, the reduction of cobalt oxide to metallic cobalt is two step process. The first step, in step one, the CO3O4 reduced to COO, and in the second step, the COO is reduced to metallic CO. The ratio of hydrogen consumed in step one to that in step two is 1:3. TPR profiles of rhenium promoted cobalt catalyst presented in this figure. There are two peaks for all the catalysts. The peak at around 350 degrees centigrade is due to the reduction of CO3O4, mostly due to the reduction of CO3O4 to COO, and the COO. The bigger cluster of COO to metallic CO, and the broad peak around 450 degrees centigrade to 750 degrees centigrade is due to the reduction of COO to metallic CO, and that metallic CO is interacting strongly with the support. With low space velocity, the 5 standard liter per hour per gram of catalyst, the CO conversion is low, but the deactivation rate is high, the 2.2% CO conversion per week, that is 14.6% CO conversion per week. If we look at the rhenium promoted cobalt alumina catalyst, the CO conversion, the deactivation rate for the CO conversion is 1.13% CO conversion per week. As compared to unpromoted catalyst at the same stress velocity, 2.2% CO conversion per week. Finally, come to the conclusion. Small amount of rhenium added to the cobalt catalyst decreases the reduction temperature of cobalt oxide. And addition of rhenium does not change the percent dispersion and cluster size based on the amount of reduced cobalt. The addition of rhenium only increases the percentage reduction, not the percentage dispersion. The addition of rhenium increases the percent of reduction of cobalt, hence the increases the activity and decreases the deactivation rate. Deactivation rate depends upon the sequence of addition of promoter, and the deactivation rate in polywax is less than that of C30 oil. That is, the polywax is a better solvent than C30 oil. A linear correlation between the CO conversion and space time has been established. And I would like to acknowledge the Department of Energy and Commonwealth of Kentucky for financial support. And I would like to thank all of my colleagues in our center. Thank you.
We have time for a couple of questions.
Dealing with some deactivation of your catalyst. And what do you think is the cause of this decline of activity?
Sorry, can you...
What is the cause? Is it metal sintering? Is there sulfur in your feed gas?
Okay.
Is there...
Actually, we don't have any clear evidence for the deactivation rate. So, maybe for the oxidation of the smaller particle, maybe the sintering of the catalyst is making bigger particle, or maybe you are making the cobalt aluminate. It's not clear yet.
Did you measure the metal dispersion after the deactivation process, of the deactivated catalyst?
Actually, there is a problem of removal of the wax from the catalyst. It's very difficult to measure the dispersion by chemical option, because we try to remove the wax by extracting the catalyst with orthoxylene, but we are not able to remove 100% of the reactor wax from the catalyst. It's very difficult to remove 100%. If you don't remove the reactor wax from the catalyst, it's very difficult to measure the chemical option.
Second, I would like to address that. Did you try to correlate your decreased deactivation in the presence of rhenium to the change of the structure of your the carbide structure of your cobalt? Because in earlier work, it was on iron rhenium system. We found that in the presence of rhenium, iron doesn't form a so-called high carbide, which is a hex carbide, which is a very inactive form, and just prevent it to form this type of carbide. And this is the deactivation rate is much slower. You didn't try to characterize your cobalt after your deactivation for the carbon structure.
Actually, the same problem will come to that removal of the wax. If you don't remove the wax, it's very difficult to characterize whether this carbide or something else is forming.